Technology.
It shapes
and reshapes our world.
The hardware and the software
make us aware of better ways of doing things.
For work or for leisure, technology can improve our lives
and re-energize our lifestyles.
We can create it
or we can adapt it.
The technology of the present can help us prepare
for a future perfect.
Hi, I'm Tony Velasquez. The cell phone, it's a device that has fundamentally changed how we communicate. Suddenly, anyone, anywhere is now just a phone call away. Unfortunately, even bombs can be triggered this way too. Here in the Philippines, the combination of cheaper devices and prepaid plans have led to an explosion of mobile phone use. But prepaid cell phones have also been used to cause a different kind of explosion, one that has bolstered calls for the long-standing proposal for SIM card registration.
Cell phones today have gone so far beyond being simple devices we used to call other people. We now use them to take photos and video, listen to music, and even play games. Terrorists have also found a new use for cell phones. They are now the preferred device for triggering bombs. In July 2002, a cell phone was used to trigger a bomb at a cafeteria at Hebrew University in Jerusalem that killed 7 people. In Iraq, improvised explosive devices, or IEDs, which use cell phones, became the weapon of choice of insurgents, leading U.S. troops on patrol to fit cell phone jammers on their vehicles. The deadly blast in Russia's Domodedovo airport, which killed 35 last January, also used an IED triggered by a cell phone. Here in the Philippines, investigators sifting through the debris of the January 26th EDSA bus blast found the shattered pieces of a cell phone along with blood and shrapnel at a crime scene. Investigators are certain that a cell phone was used to trigger the improvised explosive device, which killed 5 and wounded 13 others. Why do terrorists prefer to use cell phones to trigger bombs? It's because they're so easy to construct and deploy. You can even find a video on how to make a simple cell phone trigger on the internet. The phone's vibration function is the part used to trigger bombs. We won't go into details, but suffice to say, once assembled, the phone's alarm or a simple phone call or text completes the circuit, triggering, in this case, fireworks. It doesn't take a lot of skill and know-how. Anyone with a modest understanding of electronics and circuitry can do it. Although remote-controlled toys and keyless entry devices can set off bombs too, cell phones remain the most popular of several reasons. Their batteries have just the right power. They can be synchronized with another clock. It's easy to hack their circuitry. They're used around the world and can be bought almost anywhere along with prepaid SIM cards. And finally, even if cell network signals are jammed, the phone's alarm clock can still be used to trigger the bomb. But cell phone bombs also have disadvantages to the would-be bomber. In Russia, a suicide bomber had a premature detonation on New Year's Eve after the local carrier sent her a spam text wishing her a Happy New Year. The EDSA bus blast made lawmakers renew calls for cell phone and SIM card registration. They say this will help law enforcers track down people who use cell phones for terrorism, crime, and even for simple pranks. Telcos, which used to be against this measure, now are saying that they're open to the proposal. But they also question how the proposal may be implemented. The Philippine Chamber of Telecom Operators says there are about 75 to 80 million cell phone subscribers in the country, about 95% of whom are on prepaid plans, of which majority don't even have valid government IDs.
Well, it was proposed as early as August 2000, but so far it has failed to get off the ground due to resistance from privacy advocates, consumer groups, and even the telcos. And joining us now on Future Perfect is Cagayan de Oro Representative Rufus Rodriguez. He's one of the authors behind the latest push for the mandatory SIM card registration of all prepaid subscribers. Congressman, thank you very much for coming to the show.
Thank you, and good evening, Tony.
All right, well, this bill has other counterpart bills that have previously been filed in Congress, but then again, they were blocked, right?
In the previous Congresses, I was aware of the Congress, 12th Congress, 13th, but that was done in the 14th Congress where I was for the first time congressman. But that's the reason why that last January 12th, I filed House Bill 3940 to require prepaid SIM card registration.
Well, a lot of tech people are going to be curious as to how you crafted the bill, but did you craft it with some technical maybe consultation? Did you ask some tech people to, you know, maybe design a system that will make prepaid SIM card registration practicable and feasible?
No, this is mainly a layman's and a lawyer's view of already. It's about time to have a prepaid SIM card registration. So the details, the system, would come out when we have a committee hearing, and we'll be able to invite the NTC, we invite the telcos, we invite the DILG, and all those who would be stakeholders, so that we can come out with a system. But basically, the bill is simple. It requires that before sellers of SIM cards are can sell, they should require government-issued IDs with picture to be able to give that to the buyer. Yeah. And it can only be activated by the telcos once these personal circumstances which are found in the ID are also registered with the telcos.
Right. And the basis or the rationale for doing that precisely is because you want the subscriber to have a proven identity,
that's
hindi fake identity yung pakita niya.
That's correct, because we have a system here which is we have a SIM, subscriber identification module, but there is no identification. So that's the problem.
It's it's the number that identifies you.
Yes, but there is really no accountability and no pinpointing and no source and no identification.
Yeah.
Now the difference between a prepaid and the postpaid is that, like, we are postpaid holders, we register.
Sure.
Our names are there, our addresses are there, all the personal circumstances. But for prepaid, which is now prevalent and which are now being used by unscrupulous persons and criminals, that's the problem, because there is no requirement.
Yeah.
The telcos will just sell them as long as there is revenue, and then there's no more accountability.
Mm-hmm.
So that's being used now, as proven in the bombings of the EDSA bus in Makati.
But you know, there are tech advocates who say that maybe it's approaching the problem the wrong way, because they're looking at it from a forensic technical aspect. If you had a bombing and it was caused by a remotely triggered device using a cell phone, now, how feasible is it to actually trace the number to any particular suspect? Especially, they say, if you have fake IDs that are proliferating.
That's correct. There may be, you know, criminals are always sometimes ahead of us. They have thought of many ways to get away from the arms of the law.
Mm.
But if other countries, I have in my research, more than 30 countries in the world have required this registration. And it has made it better in terms of security. It has made it better in terms of reducing criminality. And that's the reason for this bill. The bill sees that without any identification, criminality will go unhampered. There's no chance to identify who did the call, who did the triggering mechanism for a bomb to explode, who made that crank call, who made that scam, the tech scams that are proliferating in our cell phones. All of this cannot in any way be traced, because there is no tracing mechanism.
Yeah.
And that's the reason why we have initiated this bill.
Well, the tracing mechanism, maybe that's something that has to be ironed out by the technical experts. But, you know, in crafting the bill, you did some research. You said there are about 30 countries worldwide that have actually mandated SIM card registration.
That's right.
Did your research maybe find out whether or not the SIM card registration helped them to trace suspects in a crime?
Definitely. In the research that we have made in these different countries, I can mention Singapore, Malaysia, Kenya, Canada. Certainly, this mechanism has been used really to identify perpetrators of callers, you know, those who abuse the SIM cards to be able to extract extortion, kidnapping for ransom, and that's found in the countries that we have researched. That's why we believe that if the others can do it, Tony, in the Philippines, kaya ng Pinoy yan. We can do that with the help of everybody.
Now, let's see the reasons why we can't do it. Kasi sabi ng mga naysayers, no, it's impossible. It's a waste of time and resources. They're going to point to the experiences of some African countries now, and even maybe China, which is also trying to mandate SIM card registration, that the telcos themselves are the ones that are resisting the idea because it will...
Trust is slow.
Sometimes, that's why we ask our telcos in the Philippines are different. They have this social responsibility. Mm-hmm. That's why I believe that the three big companies should be able to take a look at this, not on the expense side, but on their social responsibility to the Filipino people. Mm-hmm. The telcos have been receiving so much income. It's about time that they will share this income by providing for security for our country. And that is why, with this system, we hope the telcos will absorb the expenses for this.
Okay, so you're thinking that the telcos should set up the database for the prepaid SIM card registration and maintain it.
But that's
going to entail costs, right?
The entire system. From their sellers in the malls, who would now take down the ID and the pictures and all the personal circumstances, and then remit these records to the telcos, which will have a database. And it will only be when the sellers of these SIM cards prepaid would give the personal circumstances of the buyers, that then when it is with the telcos, these circumstances, then that's the time only.